AI is interwoven into our everyday lives. It powers ChatGPT, it's integral to data analysis in many jobs, and it's embedded in some of our favorite apps. Artificial intelligence can be found in anything from search engines to smart refrigerators. But one of the downsides is the heavy strain it puts on the environment, a problem which often gets overlooked. ChatGPT, what time is it in New York? Useful, right? But did you know that an AI chatbot consumes far more electricity than a regular search engine? And most of that energy consumption doesn't happen here, it's happening in the huge data centers that are processing my request. And for many users, out of sight means out of mind. Using AI tools like ChatGPT can be a time saver, but they're a huge drain on resources. Apart from electricity, these systems require water and metals. Training AI models requires powerful processors, mostly GPUs or graphic processing units. These are installed in servers and consume a lot of electricity.
The amount of compute power we need for things like ChatGPT 4.0 is beyond good and evil and beyond anything that can be consciously considered an environmentally sustainable path. AI systems take weeks to months to train on large computer clusters with thousands of GPUs. And these compute systems consume electricity resources that are far larger than any small city or even large cities.
The International Energy Agency predicts that by 2026, the amount of electricity needed to power data centers, artificial intelligence, and cryptocurrencies could be twice as much as in 2022. Already today, the amount of electricity used by data centers in some countries is huge.
In Ireland, for example, right now 18% of the power of the entire country goes to powering data centers, and the International Energy Agency estimates that could be as much of a third of the country's entire power by 2026. So these are really significant numbers, and these issues are really growing, not just in Europe, but around the world as well.
That's right, it's an upward trend.
At the plant, the AI plant.
US President Donald Trump has announced an investment of up to $500 billion in AI infrastructure. That means there will be many new data centers across the US, which will make the demand for energy skyrocket. This is mostly due to the current AI boom and the way the systems behind it work. AI tools like ChatGPT are oftentimes based on large language models, which are trained using lots of data. That way, they can generate an answer to almost any question. But that requires a lot of energy. Every new request triggers computations that are far more complex than what happens with a traditional search engine.
When you do a search with Google or any other classic search engine, what happens is a simple data query. That's it. With generative AI, there's a huge model behind it, and for each request, the entire model is activated.
Graphics processors tend to heat up while they're working. If you search for boiling water on a CPU, you'll find many videos like this. To prevent chips from getting damaged, they're cooled down by using fans, which also use electricity, or by using water. This is also harmful to the environment, because often, fresh water from the local supply is used.
If the water evaporates during the cooling process, then it's lost. If it gets partially redirected back into the rivers or water sources, then it can be used again. It will just be warmer, which means it will change the ecosystem of the river or water source.
Which in turn could harm that ecosystem. Chatbots like ChatGPT are estimated to need about half a liter of water to answer 20 to 50 requests. An exact number is hard to pin down, because companies aren't exactly eager to disclose figures on their water and energy consumption. There are even non-disclosure agreements included in contracts in places that house data centers. But it's becoming increasingly clear. People who live near data centers don't really benefit from them and actually have to face the environmental repercussions. More and more activists and residents are raising their voices, and they're being heard. We met up with activists in the Chilean capital, Santiago. Environmental groups in Chile are fighting back against the construction of more data centers. Many companies, including tech giant Google, have created server farms in the Santiago region, and more are being planned. Activists like Tania Rodriguez have long been sounding the alarm.
We recognize the havoc these data centers wreak on nature. Data centers that are not necessarily beneficial for Chileans, but rather for other countries in the world. They generate very few jobs, and the environmental impact is severe.
Tania Rodriguez is a member of the environmental organization Mosacat. The group is protesting the expansion of data centers in the region, including a new Google project. Mosacat activists say these data centers have a huge impact on Chile's water supply.
The data center itself would use 169 liters of water per second. That's the equivalent of nearly 9 Olympic-sized swimming pools every day, which are filled and drained, because this isn't reusable water. Given the increasing droughts we're experiencing, this is a mind-boggling waste.
Environmentalists say the data center's high water consumption puts the Quilicura wetlands at risk. Santiago does not have the luxury of large water reserves. And actually, the region is in a drought period that's predicted to stretch on for years.
Many people used to grow crops. There are places here where they used to grow strawberries, and now they can't do anything. They have to buy everything, and they don't even have water to use in the bathroom.
With government support, Santiago has become a popular location in Latin America for data centers.
Chile is attractive because our laws are lax. We have almost no legislation. Plus, there's no political responsibility.
The activists recognize that there are also advantages to AI, but they want the environmental burden of data centers to be shared more fairly with other countries.
They arrive here and want to do these huge construction projects, which are coming from Europe. So they bring them here, to Latin America.
Their protests have been successful. A Chilean court halted Google's data center project, ruling that it had to consider its environmental impact. Google has planted trees to offset emissions, but the region continues to be affected by drought. Chilean activists continue to fight for change and hope that the government will implement stricter environmental regulations in the future. Environmental regulations have repeatedly been a stumbling block for tech billionaire Elon Musk. He's known for his ambitious plans, like flying to Mars, or creating the most powerful AI system in the world. He's already built a supercomputer in Memphis. Given its impact on the local community, it's no surprise the project's been met with controversy. This is the data center where Elon Musk's AI model Grok 3 is being trained, powered by Colossus, already considered the world's largest AI supercomputer. Musk has plans to expand the computer's graphics chips to 1 million. That's unprecedented computing power, which means huge amounts of energy consumption. Musk's facility first planned to use 150 megawatts of electricity, later announcing it would need double. Methane gas turbines are also being used to supply the entire site with enough power.
Gas-powered aeroderivative turbines mounted on trailers that are spewing climate-changing emissions into this community's air right now. And this without any environmental impact statement or even a permit due to the legal loophole that they're on trailers. And they're only temporary, but actually they could be run 364 days a year.
Climate activists criticized that the construction of the facility was rushed and completed in just a few months without consulting the public. That's why they're engaging with the community about the supercomputer and its impact on the environment. It's abundantly clear that something needs to change when it comes to energy consumption in data centers. For example, reducing energy consumption of chips and servers by making them more efficient. The US company NVIDIA unveiled an AI supercomputer for the home that is very powerful. AI models are supposed to run on it, and it's supposed to consume far less energy than standard supercomputers. Could this reduce the need for data centers? We'll see. Meanwhile, Google and Oracle are looking to construct mini nuclear power plants to generate enough power for their data centers. Sure, nuclear energy is tied to lower carbon emissions, but it also produces highly toxic nuclear waste. In my opinion, that is not the solution. Unfortunately, energy consumption and water usage aren't the only environmental issues linked to AI systems. There's yet another one. Data centers need metals like silicon, copper, gold, and aluminium, which are used in computer chips. When these resources are mined, forests are cleared, and toxic substances are released. Plus, producing the metals requires a lot of energy, and generative AI puts incredible strain on chips.
Because they're under high load, chips need to be replaced more often, meaning they don't last for 5 or 6 years, but rather only 3 or 4. And then everything gets thrown away and replaced.
And that's exactly the issue. Most of this stuff does not get recycled, which makes electronic waste a major environmental hazard. A Chinese-Israeli research team estimates 2.5 million tons of additional e-waste could be accumulated annually by 2030. All of this e-waste due to generative AI and large language models. And the thing about these current models is they're trained to do it all, which can be a problem, according to Paris Marx.
Possibly. The thing with these generative AI models that are being made right now is that these companies are trying to make models that can do everything, right? Generalizable models that, you know, you can ask it one question, you can ask it another, you can ask it to do any number of things, and it can try to do them all based on the same model. It's possible to make models that are more tailored to specific use cases that use less energy and that require less water and less computation. And so that is potentially a better way forward, but that doesn't work so much for the companies, and that's not what they're pursuing right now.
I, for one, would like to see generative AI used more consciously. Do I really need to speak to my refrigerator? Or are all these images from Copilot really necessary? And tech companies especially should be taking more responsibility, more awareness when it comes to the AI boom, and the consequences for us and our environment would go a long way. That's it for today. Bye, and see you next time.